What's that you got cooking?
Apple juice stew with apple juice.
Didn't we have that yesterday? Or the day before?
No. Yesterday, it was baked apple dew with apple dews. And the day before, it was fried apple dews.
With apple dews. Oh, I remember now.
Sorry, I'm doing what I can to switch up our meals. But in my defense, we have a pretty limited set of ingredients.
Hey, I wasn't complaining. I'm glad that you're doing the cooking. Otherwise, I'd be eating, I guess, apple juice.
Oh, did you have a chance to look at the engine?
Yeah. It does seem like it took some damage upon landing, but I should be able to fix that real quick.
Awesome.
Your butt's awesome.
Say it again to my face. With the lights off? Works for me.
No. I didn't do that. Ugh, we must have run out of flow.
Weren't you supposed to charge up the nest today?
Excuse me if I was working on the engine. I can't do everything.
No worries. I'll go get some more outside. If I'm lucky, I'll stumble upon something to spice up the apple dews.
I'll come with you. Over there, a flow thread. Apple juice again.
Who knows how long we're gonna be stuck here? We might as well stock up.
Oh, sorry, birds.
Whoops. Try again. Well, that was a bust. We were too slow.
No biggie. Plenty of threads out there. Perfect.
Although it seems like one thread won't be enough.
No worries, we'll find others.
Have you ever seen such a thing?
No, never. Must be an endemic species. And I know it wasn't here yesterday. I mean, 24 hours ago. You know what I'm saying. I wonder if it's edible.
Only one way to find out.
Yes, you're right. I'll pick up some berries and run some tests. First, we'll need to observe any cutaneous reactions. Then we'll cook them to eliminate bacteria.
Mmm. It's peppery.
You did not.
Go ahead. Try it. I'm sure you'll love it.
Oh, yeah. That is peppery.
Lightweight. Off we go. Let's pick these.
I'm not sure these will go great with the apple dews. But where there's a meal, there's a way.
You know what doesn't go great with apple dews? Apple dews. Just like that.
How many more do you think we need?
I don't know. Three? Maybe four?
Good thing there are plenty of flow threads around here. really think drifting is that useful?
It's crucial. It allows you to change direction without having to stop all the time.
Do I do that?
We all do it. It isn't ripe yet.
A pretty one.
We're gonna need more flow than this for the batteries to make it. One or two more threads, and we'll be all set. All right, I'm all charged up.
Me too. We can go when you're ready. Good. This should last us a few days.
Now it's our turn to fill up.
Huh?
I'm hungry.
Done. Roasted apple dews with apple dews.
I can't tell if you're actually excited about this, or if you just enjoy seeing me suffer.
How long do you think this is gonna last?
The flow? Well, if we keep our consumption in check, I think a few days.
No, I meant us. Us here. How long until they come get us?
Do we have to talk about this?
We are going to need to at some point. We need to be prepared. We need a plan.
I'm planning on finishing my plate without hearing about the apiary. Is that okay?
Okay. Okay.
And FYI, you are the one that ruined the mood, not me.
We've already eaten too much.
I can never eat too much.
Okay, I've already eaten too much.
Wow, these floating islands are really something.
Yeah. Never imagined I would ever see this. Do you think it's time to go to bed?
If you say so.
You?
All right. Let's talk about it. Fine.
I was just gonna ask if you could switch off the light.
Oh.
You've been mulling it over this whole time?
Of course I've been mulling it over this whole time. Thank you for adding one more thing to my mind.
Hold on. Are you telling me you hadn't thought about it before?
You know what? No, I hadn't thought about it. I'm trying not to think about the apiary. Enjoy what we have here, even if it isn't much. Do you really think that they can come get us here?
If we could take the flow bridge here, then so can they.
But there's no way they can know where we are, is there? I cut off the auto nav, the astrolock. Even the landing was all manual.
I'm just saying, let's prepare for the worst.
At worst, I kill them.
Whoa, you.
What? If that's what it takes not to go back, I'll do it. No problem. Kill them, steal their ship. By the time they send more guys, we'll be far away.
You're seriously not considering...
Maybe not. Maybe I am. At worst, we'll know.
You're scaring me.
Oh, come on. You're totally safe. You're my teddy bear.
I'm not sure how I should take this.
Well, take me in your arms for a start.
You aren't dressed yet?
I put on my pajamas.
I mean, to get out.
Well, see, I was just wondering, do we have to get out? Can't we just hang in the nest for once? Lounge around, read a book, watch a movie?
We don't have movies.
Right, sure, but you know what I mean.
Come on, the weather's great.
But the weather is always great.
For now. Who knows? Tomorrow could be the beginning of the long winter months. Could last for years. One more reason to stock up on apple juice.
You know, always being right is not necessarily a good quality. On the contrary, many people find it very unappealing.
You?
Not sure.
Do you remember where the apple juice were?
Could we try and pick something else for a change?
Is it me, or is the ground shaking?
It's shaking. It's shaking a lot. Is it over?
Seems like it. Anything broken?
No. No, I don't think so. Well, except...
It's not all lost.
Well, it is. A bit.
Look, we can always search the islet, try and find a way to get to the other side.
Such as...
I don't know. A rope, a jetpack, spring-loaded shoes, anything.
And if we don't find it?
If we don't find... I don't know. That's why we'll have to find something.
Okay. That was the wrong way. I think I found something.
Huh?
Call me crazy, but this looks like a blutin?
Yep, it looks like a flow bridge. Kind of like the one we took to get here, but smaller?
Is that possible?
Why not? We still don't really know how the flow bridges work in space, but if the phenomenon can happen on a macro scale, then why not on this one? If there can be flow between two planets, why not two bits of a planet?
Okay. If this really is a flow bridge, I'm not sure what we're waiting for.
What?
Flow bridges are linking one place to another, right? So this one definitely leads someplace.
Wait, you want to just get on there without knowing where it goes?
It goes elsewhere. I think that's as good a start as any. Do we have everyone? Kay?
Here.
Then we're good.
Looks like we're on another islet.
Yeah. The bridge seems to be a link between the islets. If there are any others like this, we may be able to get back to the nest.
Make sure they don't get squished. This is where we came from. Do you see what I'm seeing?
A big ugly lizard?
No, the mushrooms on its back. Looks like a type of hygrocybruescence.
Ah, is that good news? Like, can we eat it?
Oof, not at all. Unless you're looking for a quick way to unload your kidneys. But don't you find that symbiosis amazing? The movements of the lizard are helping spread the spores. As far as what the lizard is gaining, I'll have to study that closer.
Maybe it doesn't even know. Maybe we should tell it.
No way. You don't get in the way of Mother Nature's plans.
I'll make sure I remember that next time you have salad stuck in your teeth.
Flow bridge wasn't a unique occurrence.
Good, because those things are really useful. Do you think that's impressive? We can fly too. Watch out. I'm not sure our boots will fare too well in the water.
Oh, could they get damaged?
No way. They're waterproof. But you won't exactly grip the track underwater. That's better.
What is better?
Oh, nothing. Got a big one. Wow, that's actually, what is that?
We should take a closer look. I thought it smelled good around here.
Any idea what's underneath our feet, Mr. Geologist?
I'm a biologist.
Isn't that the same thing?
Biology, the living. Geology, the rocks.
And what makes you think this is not living, pray tell?
It looks like a dust deposition. Some kind of rust. And it looks like this kind of rust is particularly sensitive to flow.
What?
Look beneath your feet.
Oh, there's vegetation underneath. It was probably smothered.
Good thing we came this way.
That way, look.
Great. We can bring that back to the nest to study it. Even the appledew shrubs are completely covered.
I hope this one will yield some nice and juicy fruit to thank us. Another flow bridge.
That's great. It means there must be others. If we're lucky, they'll bring us back to the nest.
We almost missed this one. For here or to go?
To go.
Too bad.
Right.
Saw that. We should find the nest if we keep going north.
Explain to me how you know which way north is on this planet.
We should find the nest if we keep going straight ahead.
Thank you.
Now I'm hungry.
I know, right? Come on. Don't be scared.
A big bug like you.
Yum.
I thought this planet was supposed to be a desert.
Deserted, not a desert. According to the archives, a colonization plan had been considered by the Apiary, with Exanova as the main provider. But the planet was eventually classified as inhospitable.
Let me guess. Is it because of that rusty stuff?
I don't know. The file doesn't say anything about that.
I hope we don't have any more unpleasant surprises. Another one.
Bob, aren't we the lucky ones?
What are they?
You've never heard of boba nuts? They're one of the most nutritious nuts. 25% carbohydrates, 50% protein, 75% lipids.
Great. But how does it taste?
Didn't you hear what I said? 75% fat. Of course it tastes great.
We're gonna get stuffed. This is so slow. We're not going anywhere.
So?
The nest.
But in what state?
Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. There is no way this thing is flying again.
Don't say that. You could make a rock fly with the right tools.
Well, maybe. But not this one. Both wings are wasted. The propellers were ripped off. And I'm not even done checking the inside.
We weren't really planning on leaving, were we? We don't really have another place to go anyway.
I'm tired. Why are we always so unlucky? Why are you laughing?
Hold on. We decide to escape the apiary, which apparently no one has managed to do before us. We punch in some coordinates really at random, only because some obscure document from Exanova vaguely attested to the existence of a habitable planet. By some kind of miracle, we cross the boundaries of the apiary without getting caught. We travel across space in a Class D ship that is totally not designed for that. And in spite of the fact that this is not all terrain, we land without breaking anything. We find food and flow on site, even though we hadn't really planned for it. Finally, we get hit with an earthquake, all right, but we get out of it unscathed. The only real consequence is that the nest is a little bit busted. And you think that we're unlucky? You. We are the luckiest people in the universe.
That's one way to see it.
This planet is our chance to start a new life. With our own rules. Away from the apiary, from the matchmaker and all that loot. And I'd rather endure 1,000 earthquakes than risk being away from you.
What did you say this planet was called again?
Source.
Source. The beginning of something.
Seems like it.
Whoa, what a mess. And now the nest is all akimbo. This feels weird.
Yeah, we'll need to find a way to correct that. But it can wait until tomorrow. I think we've had our share for the day. We deserve some time to relax. If you know what I mean.
You can do whatever you want, but I am going to bed. Come on, let's go to bed instead. I've had enough for this day.
You okay? You? Wake up! It's okay. I'm here. That was just a nightmare. Everything's fine.
That wasn't a nightmare.
Sure it was. Rest easy.
No! I was awake. I could hear you. I just couldn't move or yell. I couldn't breathe. It was horrible.
Yeah, seemed like it was. Do you want my opinion? I'm not a dream expert or anything, but...
It wasn't a dream. I wasn't sleeping. My eyes were wide open.
No, your eyes were closed.
I'm telling you, they were open. I saw everything. You, the room, everything.
Okay. Okay. What I meant was that it may have been because of the nest.
What?
You said you couldn't move. You were nailed to the bed. A bit like the nest, which is stuck to the ground, right? You've been flying in this thing for years. I bet you're upset to see it in this condition.
Huh. No kidding. Which means that if we fix up the nest, this will all go away?
Could be. Worst case scenario, the nest will be fixed.
Yeah. Well, I hope we'll eventually find the missing parts then, so I can get fixed up too.
All right, now we can see a lot clearer.
Yeah,
We're not there yet, but that should do the trick for now. Now we just need to figure out how to level the nest. The tractor globe is probably done charging. Let's bring it outside.
Do you think it'll be enough to lift it?
I hope so, because I have no idea what else we can do.
What are you looking at?
The distance between us and the apiary.
I wouldn't expect it to change.
Exactly. It's comforting. There's kind of an apple dew taste.
It's in there.
Hey, you never told me. What did your mate look like?
I don't know.
Didn't you get her file from the matchmaker?
Yeah, I did, but I never really looked at it.
Seriously? You're not even curious?
Well, no. I already knew you.
Whatever. Come on, we'll look at it together.
If you wish.
Oh, all right. Any other pictures?
Yeah.
She's kind of cute.
You think so?
Yeah, definitely. Don't you?
Yeah. Yeah. Now that you mention it.
Ugh, as if you needed me to have an opinion about a girl.
I'm sorry. I have the most beautiful of them all with me, 24/7. I need a little bit of time so I can forget her face and give the other ones a chance.
You're such an idiot. Come on, let's check her profile instead of this foolishness. Let's see. Interests: reading, music, having a drink with my friends. Whoa, do you think you can handle such a strong personality?
That's harsh.
Job: ocean biology research assistant at the University of Ox. Huh. Okay. Looks like you two are made for each other.
No one is made for each other. That's the kind of rhetoric the matchmaker uses.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. But it still looks to me like that was a blooting good pick. You'd make a great couple.
Might have made. There's a difference. It did feel a bit weird at first, but now I can't even tell the nest is tilted. I guess I got used to it.
What? No. You cannot get used to it. We're gonna get the nest out of this crevasse. I don't wanna get used to it. What if we grabbed a little snack for the road?
Huh. Sounds good. I'll bring the first aid kit as well, just in case.
Did it move?
No, I don't think so.
Bulging blunt! Ugh, it's over. It's not going back straight. We'll never be able to fix it. We are condemned to living on an incline in a broken ship forever, until our body adapts and one of our legs starts shrinking to even us out.
What's the issue exactly?
Well, the back pain will be crazy, for one. And also, I don't know about you, but I personally like having a reasonably symmetrical body.
I meant with the tractor globe.
Ah, not enough power, it seems like. The battery drains out even before lifting the nest a centimeter off the ground. Although, to be fair, it was originally designed to lift cargo crates into ships, not the ships themselves.
What if we plugged it into a flow spring?
I thought about that, but we'd have to be able to seal the pipe shut. Unfortunately, I don't think they make gaskets for flow springs from a distant planet.
Perhaps we can make one.
With what? Paper mache?
Remember yesterday when I told you that rust scatters when it comes in contact with flow? We could use that feature to sculpt a gasket out of pieces of rust.
You could do that?
I don't think I could sculpt a nude statue of you or a super complex component, but molding a gasket, that seems doable.
That's awesome!
Hold on, let's not start pushing before the panties are pulled down.
Excuse me?
You've never heard of that saying?
No.
Must be a truth thing then. That means let's not celebrate before we...
Yeah. I got it. Anyway, how much rust do you need in order to pull the panties down?
I don't know. 4 or 5 blocks like those we already got?
Okay, so let's try and find that. I won't be able to fix the nest if we don't pull it out of this hole first. Sorry, I kind of missed my U-turn.
We'll do better next time.
Scared them.
Sweet old tractor globe. Doing its best. Even though it'll never work without a new gasket. See that? Looks like there's some flow hiding underneath.
Yeah. Weird. It looks like a flow bridge that's begging to pop out.
Like a budding flow bridge?
Perhaps. If we wait long enough...
Or we could come back later.
Fine with me.
This one is nice and ripe.
This way is also full of rust.
Not for long.
Here, another big chunk.
We probably should grab some more, just to be sure.
For us to make the gasket, okay?
For sure.
Okay.
What?
Everything.
Great. We're stacking up. Come on. Just a little more rust and we'll be set. Be careful. These creatures don't seem to be in their right mind.
I did notice that.
Dodge this one! All right, that's it! All right, that's it! Are you okay?
One of them is weakened. We should be able to pacify it.
Copy that.
One to go. Shielding.
Perfect. Wait, settle down. Now's the time. Bye-bye.
We make a good team. And now he's back to being sweet. Seems like it was the rust that made him aggressive.
I'd do the same if I were them.
What?
Think about it this way. You wake up in the morning with a rash covering your body. If you scratch it, it gets worse. If you don't scratch it, it still gets worse. Of course you're gonna lash out first chance you get.
I don't think this is the same thing.
Of course it is. Tell her Oink. Tell Kay that I'm right. Oink. His name is Oink now.
Watch out! You almost ran into me.
Why were you hanging back anyway?
I think that's enough rust to cover up the attractive globe joint.
Are we leaving then?
Ready when you are.
What does she want from us?
Wow!
Done and done.
Yes!
okay?
Ugh. You know, I am starting to get tired of being beat up by every critter that comes around.
It's not their fault. It's the rust that's pushing them to act against their will.
So, if I understand you correctly, you're telling me that you're siding with the critter that beat up your girlfriend?
Can we rewind a bit?
Oh no, too late, funny guy. Now you'll have to be twice as sensitive to my needs while I recover from these wounds.
Understood. All right, I guess it's time for me to do what I do best.
Snuggle?
I was more thinking about gathering strange plants with medicinal properties.
We already have some medic kits.
Oh yeah, we do.
Then I guess we just need to find a place to lay low and care for your injuries.
Another thing from home. How many do you think X and Nova built before they realized it wouldn't work?
I guess they knew what they were doing. Having worked for them, I can tell you they don't just throw money around.
Knowing my mom, I'm not surprised. Still though, it shouldn't take years of research and observation to realize that this planet is scattered around like a jigsaw puzzle. You don't just see this and think, ooh, this place is nice. We should settle it.
That's what we did.
But we didn't have much of a choice. Why did my mom never mention any of this to me? I don't think Xenova wins colonization contracts on the regular.
These buildings look kind of old. Your mom may not have been head of the company then. She may not have been with the company at all.
Yeah, that's possible. Still, it's weird.
Agreed. I guess we'll figure it out eventually.
It could always be useful.
Are we saving those for later?
Of course.
Get them!
On your feet!
What happened?
That looks bad. Don't you want to sit?
No, thanks. Just bending my leg hurts. Oh. Do you know if we have any medicine left in the cabinet?
I don't remember. But we can always synthesize new ones.
I think I need a good night's sleep.
And I need a good meal. Are you all right? You realize you're hogging the covers?
I didn't do it. The nest did.
Excuse me?
The nest is tilted. The duvet is slowly sliding my way.
Okay, let's switch places then.
As you wish. But since the nest is tilted, I'll probably roll toward you. And then you'll complain I'm hogging the whole bed.
Well, if you wake up on the ground tomorrow, don't ask why. Don't blame me. Blame the tilted nest.
All right, give me those medical plants of yours. Time to fire up the synthesizer. With this thing, we'll be right back on our feet.
Are you sure you know how?
I have a synthesizer in my ship. Of course I know how these work.
No, wait, that's not the way.
I know what I'm doing.
Really? Because at this stage, you should...
Look, I've always done it this way, and it's always worked out. You're not gonna tell me how to use my own synthesizer.
All right, as you wish.
Aha! There! What do you say about that?
All right. I didn't know you could also do it that way.
And?
Sorry I doubted you.
And?
I love you?
Okay. That's not what I was expecting, but it'll do. Okay, we need to talk.
Should I be worried?
Yes. No. Maybe. Promise me you won't be mad.
I can't promise anything without knowing what this is about.
It's about your skidding skills.
Oh.
Let's just say that you could use some extra training.
Okay, show me.
You're not mad?
Why would I be mad? I love to learn new things. I think we've got everything we need to mold a joint.
All right, let's hop on a few threads to practice. Skid!
Keep it going. Now! Skid! Now you have a handle on this. Perfect.
I have to say, I have an ex.
Hey, isn't that Oink? That is definitely him. That's Oink.
What's happening, big guy? Why are you here? You missed us, didn't you?
I bet he felt lonely on his empty islet.
You do realize that we can't take you along on our journeys, don't you? That would be too exhausting for you.
But you can stay with us next to the nest if you want.
No funny business, though.
Fits. That's a good sign. Let's get this ball rolling.
What?
What? Haven't you heard of that one either?
Oh no, I have. It's just a really old-fashioned saying.
Let's get this show on the road.
Okay, that's worse.
Can you just switch on the tractor globe, please?
Okay. We did it. Now, we just need to fix up the wings and the turbine and the hypo-propellers and...
Don't be so cynical. Getting the nest out of the crevasse was quite a feat.
Huh? No, don't get me wrong. I am genuinely delighted. I love fixing things up. But I don't think we need to get started right away.
That's a relief.
This isn't gonna go very far without Rust.
So, what's the plan exactly? Walking right back to this dead end?
What?
This is the path we took when we were separated from the nest. There's nothing there.
I know. I just want to make sure we didn't miss anything.
Huh. Works for me.
This one's a little rotten, isn't it?
You're a little rotten.
Huh?
Sorry, it was a reflex. For cooking.
That's it. That was the last one.
Clearly. We're breathing a lot easier without all this rust. isn't this the bridge we took to get here?
It is.